Channel 9, where I work. Okay. Taking some home movies to remember this by.
Well, bless your heart. Why didn't you tell me so? Let me fix this place up. Don't take a gift. Let me fix this place up.
Oh, it looks marvelous.
I want somebody to take a picture so I can send this to my mama. I've been telling her about this fantastic place. And believe it or not, this gives me the out. Say hello. Oh, it's fantastic.
Dave, you have anything to say?
Yeah, hi. How you doing? Gonna miss you if you ever leave. Hope you miss me if I leave.
No.
Yes, ma'am. Smile, Betsy.
Are you nuts?
Yeah, Jim, and I'm gonna be there when you're directing too, babe.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Are we going to send this to Mike?
Sure, if you want.
It's a lot lighter.
I know, aren't they?
Is the mic on?
Yeah.
Are you rolling now?
Yeah, babe. Sorry.
Call me, babe.
I didn't mean to, Jim.
Come on in, Jim.
Tell me what you're doing.
I'm waiting with Mr. Kites here so we can rip his scripts for the newscast.
Okay. Say hi, Sid.
This is already done.
You got him there.
Yep, what's the deal?
With this? Just home movies, right, Larry? Say hi. That way, when you're big and famous someday, I'll...
The hell is that?
Here's little Cam.
Do you people realize what you're doing to me?
Matt, you look, you buttoned your top button.
Yeah, the guy owns the joint.
That's right.
Face the car 11
I don't know.
In the newsroom, Greg Reams. Oh, that's attractive.
Yeah, what did you call, like, right after I talked to Gumby? Because I, like, called and went downstairs and came back, like, two or three minutes later, and nobody ever called after that.
Yeah, I did.
Small camera you got
Dr.
there,
Dean Del, Tripper. Syndicate.
Packs a wallet, though, Greg.
Okay.
Ripping the scripts, Sid Kites.
Sid doing what he does best.
No, I think you hug best, Sid.
How do I?
Janet Gross on the left. The director's bench. Matt Lucan on the right.
Why'd you stop your pants?
Huh? Oh, I gotcha. Being hurled upon. Pat Burns, producer. 5'10". Mike Mansoor. Hey.
Can you edit? You're hired.
Denny Jansen. John Popovich. Really?
Who even got my $100 back? My mom accused me of blowing it, you know? Just flagging the test, so I'm gonna have to go to St. X. Do you ever shut that thing off? That's the first thing a good camera man learns to do is shut it off.
That's right.
Gary Herman hanging out in the other end of sports. Here we have before ourselves Mike Pretot at prompter. Mike M.J. Pretot, that's what we call him. As we see here, the scripts that were being torn are now placed oh so nicely before him. And they get put on this thing. And then the words that run across this little conveyor belt zapped into the camera and put on the prompter. And let me get in close on the prompter. We got it. And that's what the prompter looks like. Sound on tape. Oh, yes. Beautiful. Mike, is there anything you can say in closing?
Just keep it centered. Just always keep it centered.
Okay, this is the state-of-the-art Channel 9 lighting board right here. And all these little switches, which are the different auxiliary, your monitors, small monitors, large monitors, desk room lights, pop-up panels, WeatherTech. This is your front fader. We turn this down at 11 to give it that silhouette effect. These are all your back lights. This is your psych lights, turn these up, And if you want to change to brown, you pull this here. Chip can explain that more fully into what it does. And that's about it. This is the light board.
That's it from the light board. Thank you, MJ. We're going to fade again. Here's that effect coming. Whoa! It's Matt Lucan with water. Let me get in. As you can see, I have my own water glass.
That's what makes this lineup so much better than it was last year.
Prominently displayed.
Hey, you unbuttoned your button like it usually is, though.
I'm sorry.
It's usually buttoned up because he's... Oh, that's problems. Let's see what the rest of the gang's doing. This is gonna be great. Larry in the background. Gumby on the floor. Quick look at the studio if we can. Studio B over there. There's the WeatherTech area. Not a very good shot, but we'll come back to it later. Jan Gross. I'm reading in the background. Jim Timmerman up front. The big guys.
The big guys.
The big guys. There's John Matarsi sitting down there with his typewriter.
John Matarsi.
Betsy Ross on the go.
It's only a 5-minute tape, so if that was it, that's
it. Let's pop that out and turn it around.
Okay, what I'm going to pull here is a bite of Murray Sailor. I've got your new old shots laid down as far as what. 43. Correct date,
correct time. Walking up into the control room. Susan,
Sid, LaDonna.
Don't eat Chip.
I'm trying not to.
Busy up your
chip. Sure.
Now make sure you get this. Blackmail video, you know.
Wow, this is great. And LaDonna.
See what happens, you get these cameras in here.
People start doing stuff. This is on camera, Sid. Okay. Not the audio. The background is...
Okay, they may not be... You may not be able to talk to them.
There's mass control.
You may just, you know, call up. Look the switch.
Okay, we'll get back.
I hope so. Can they be calling by ours?
Yeah.
Somebody's going to buy ours.
Why pay $80,000 when you can have these, like, $6?
They're not going to retire these?
Well, I give them to somebody.
Some school.
Jacket Bob?
No. Probably nice. Go to UC's.
I like that one. Thank you. You haven't worn it?
No. Are you sure? Broadcasting museum.
I don't think so. I'm sorry about it.
These things probably go to UC's Antique Broadcasting Museum.
Which is, ironically enough, the same as the broadcasting school.
What's this for, Chip? Why are
we taking it? Just for my own use.
Well, I tell you what, you must be awfully bored.
Mike checked that
off. He's not bored. It's that life is bored with
him. Mike checked.
Yeah, it's too bad to shift
a lot in campus
today.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
Mm-hmm.
1 minute.
That's a little bit contrary to what I said over here. That answered
the
question.
You got any fat and jerk? Can you squeeze together?
Yes,
but I also did believe that he'd been drinking and that impaired his ability to drive. No question about it.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
What's this guy doing? Answering questions or?
You're requested. Let me take out your gum. But since you're only going to ask a question.
You're going to sell these, are you?
That could be if it's something good happens. There's mayhem.
It's a violation, but it might not be.
I think perhaps you should do it.
30 seconds.
Oh, right.
Some bit, yeah, but it depends on how much it was, sort of whether that part would have the action.
Well, no, I mean, if you did that, and you and Chip, it would be like Velcro.
Thank you all very much for coming. Good to see you.
Pull back with us.
Coming up, President Reagan leaves for this week's summit.
And here in the tri-state, an argument in Claremont County ends in a double shooting that leaves one man dead.
Manager will be looking for a new job. I'll have that story coming up on Channel 9 News.
A small chance of showers tomorrow morning, but a real good chance of frosty weather tomorrow night. I'm Bob Allen with the Tri-State Forecast.
No more days off for Doug Llewellyn. The Boston Red Sox is seeking revenge with a vengeance. I'm Dennis Chance. The details coming up in sports.
I'm Carol Williams.
And I'm Pat Larson. Those stories and a live report on Cy Murray's firing in San Diego, all next from the Channel 9 News.
10 seconds to the open.
You get that one?
Here comes the open.
Himself at odds with San Diego City Council on how to run the city, and those conflicts finally came to a head last night. Council voted 7-1 to show Murray the door. Our Joe Garrett standing by in San Diego now. Joe?
Well, San Diego's always had a pretty peculiar political climate. Its mayor, as I recall, was in court not long ago on criminal charges.
Joe Garrett, thank you. We'll be talking with you later. Cheryl?
That here in Cincinnati, the news of Murray's ouster took people by surprise, especially the people who worked with him. Cindy Benson reports Murray earned a lot of respect in Cincinnati.
His way of saying he would encourage economic development. In retrospect, some say Murray helped accomplish those goals, but others remark that when Murray came to Cincinnati, there were already 5 cranes in place. FOP President Elmer Dunaway says Murray started out strong in Cincinnati.
You can rely on people in City Hall who have been making bad decisions prior to him coming here, and then he was taking their
place. President Reagan today, the American fire shot down a six-year-old and had involved the U.S. government, including the White House, briefing before his meeting with Gorbachev, and reported to ask about the property of the F-28. Two Americans were killed when a transport plane was gunned down.
Squeeze back.
back music up, reveal it, put the Obi-Tarawan open and the Zahabadi walk, found that out, and we're going to get it down.
The only tape we're missing now, Sid, is Mr. Wizard.
There's Wayne, Norm, and tapes, and there's the tape 19 and 20. Kind of like a tour of what it's like in real TV.
Tapes.
Just that setting up a
house. 3/4 inch tape.
Wow. This is what they call home. I've had it. I got it at a Sight and Sound about.
Mr. Wizard.
About a year ago, Norm.
We have audio tapes.
20 machines.
17-year-old Lola Holder, the mother of a two-month-old baby, is
film
wasting
machine.
Her time. She can't turn back the hands of time.
Yeah.
Instead, she's continuing her education and learning how to become a better
These
kids are older.
I've been looking at some of these millimeters with all the benefits.
Really?
Around here, they sell for about $1,300, $1,400, but I get a New York for about $1,080.
Here's our weather watchers report. Our rescue with a report on sky condition temperature around the tri-state region. 68 clear at Fort Mitchell, Independence 65, 73 at Alexandria, Price Hill 69, 70 at Madera Fairfield 67, Lawrenceburg 72, 70 at Peebles, and 68 at Harrison. Here's the way it looks from the satellite, all clear so far. Here's the clouds, Kentucky, western Tennessee moving to the north. Some of the showers may be triggered because there's a cold front drifting through the Great Lakes to the south. Matter of fact, the airflow looks this way. Southwest wind keeping us, along with the sunshine today, into the 70s. Southwest airflow feels good. We'll change things around a little bit because that frontal system will drop down all the way through the tri-state region and the Ohio Valley within the next 24 hours. When it passes through the Cincinnati area, that's what will trigger some showers. Widely scattered and very light variety, but we expect that to be tomorrow morning. Then the airflow will shift around once again, very strong from the north-northeast, and that will give us a chance after the mostly cloudy skies leave us to clear things up for tomorrow night. It'll be cold overnight tomorrow night. The daytime highs as that cool front passes through will drop from our 72 now within 24 hours to 62 degrees. The specifics of our forecast coming up at 6. Now here's more from Pat and Carol. Thanks, Rob.
And just
ahead,
the singing cowboy on the baseball playoff trails.
Did you get my good side, Jim?
You know I did.
Call upstairs, 9-2 Boston in a ninth.
No, in the ninth. There's a revised score, 9-2 Boston in the ninth.
Yeah. We're going to talk about that.
Boston.
You're going to lose about 20 seconds.
Why is that?
Very fast cost.
Did we take time out of weather?
They were rushed also.
I mean, was Bob Cole losing time, or he was just moving along?
Well, kind of the same thing.
Yeah. Boss told me to read slow.
30 seconds. I mean, we can't move Boss to be nice. I'm not angry. I'm going to work with Peace Corps.
Peace Corps, the toughest job you'll ever love.
There you go, Rosie.
Oh,
thanks
for
coming on.
The restaurant? He thinks everything big is better.
25 seconds.
Rosie is 25 seconds.
What's that? Not fast enough? See, Bobby's fast?
15 seconds.
Oh,
but he ain't big boy. Come on,
scrub,
Bob.
Sounds like
it
looks tougher
than me, huh?
Get your arm up here.
No, Bernie.
Stand by. Howdy, the tucker, quarterback. Sorry, it looks like a typical day at the cafe. I frequent. You bring us news of a tide that is turning in Boston.
The Autumn Classic, the Fall Classic, the Autumnal Special, I guess you could call it. Game 2 of the American League Championship Series at Fenway Park
in Boston continues even as I speak. There's the score, 9-2 Boston on top in the ninth inning. That after the Angels took the opener last night, 8-1. Now momentarily we'll preview the Houston-New York Mets matchup, which comprises the National League version that gets underway tonight in Houston. Let's talk about now who is going to win, or let's amend that to who should win, when the whole ball of wax, the World Championship of Baseball.
That's a California shake.
The LA lady, Deborah Snow.
Like the deepest of my heart, that I think Chip is one hell of a man.
Wow.
And he makes me laugh all the time, as a matter of fact. I just couldn't do the weekend show without him there.
Fade to black.